What's going on, guys? This is Retro Ace here, and today I'm going to be playing a little bit of a 3D platformer called Suzy Cube. Now, as far as I know, this hasn't been released on any consoles or anything like that, so something exclusive to PC. But anyways, I took a look at it, and it kind of looked a little derivative of Super Mario 3D Land, which, by all accounts, is fine by me because I fucking love that game. Stars a cute little rabbit character, I think, but without further ado, we're just gonna get into this. Oh no, they're stealing things. Honestly, it reminds me a little bit of the character from Fez. Just a little bit. I kind of like how this is all pantomime. I always love that approach to storytelling in games. But then again, does it really need to be a plot per game like this? Okay, I guess there isn't a punch button or anything like that. The camera angle is definitely giving off the 3D Land / 3D World vibes. The character kind of dashes automatically. I don't think I can push anything for that to happen. A little odd, but I can get used to it. Okay, I reckon we do not have a double jump here. Free guy already. I guess this is gonna be a lot like 3D platformers in the sense that you just get a shit ton of lives that you never really need or, you know, have to worry about running out of. Okay, yeah, no, I wonder where they got this from. Okay, so I guess it's, 3 stars per level, kind of like the star coins. But, so far, I gotta say, this game handles, really well. Control-wise, the movement is really nice and fluid. I don't think it's gonna really cause me any problems unless they tack, other things on for the sake of variety, which, who knows. I guess it's kind of like those binoculars in 3D Land where you can kind of see from afar. I guess there's just gonna be like points like that throughout the game. What's this? I can do anything about that. I'm guessing it's gonna be one of those situations where there's some other power-up introduced later on that I have to go back and grab that with. I think I'm gonna need a running start for that. Let's see if I can get it. There we go. Nice. I will say, even if the music is chiptune and a little out of place for a 3D platformer, it doesn't sound half bad, if I'm completely honest. This interface kind of looks mobile-like, but then again, this was, to my understanding, an iOS and Android game before they ported it over to Steam. But, quality-wise, so far, it definitely doesn't feel like a mobile game. Which I like. Boy. Yeah, these set pieces remind me, of some of the levels in 3D Land. which, again, I'm not complaining. It's very clear what they were inspired by, but it's nice because I really enjoy 3D Land, 3D World. I know people kind of have polarizing viewpoints on those, but as far as I'm concerned, they're pretty fantastic, if I'm honest. I'd rather see another Mario game in that style as opposed to another new Super Mario Bros. Game, because those have kind of been milked dry at this point. I feel like that's a particular, like, set of Mario games, which they're good, but really only if you, you know, play one or two of them. You know, if you try and play them all, or like all, you know, in a row or something like that, I feel like you would just get burnt out tremendously. That's my opinion. Maybe after they make Super Mario Maker 2, they'll do something like a Mario Land 3D World kind of maker where you can make 3D levels. That would be really, really cool. Although I know Project Dreams is it? I know that's gonna allow people to kind of make their own 3D platformer from the looks of it. Although, on that one, I'm kind of just waiting for them to move past the beta, because to my understanding, that just has the creation part of it, and to be honest, I kind of don't want to have to sit down and kind of learn that. Not right now, anyways. Yeah, I know it's made by Media Molecule. They make Big Planet, and I remember those tutorials for the creation part of it kind of being lengthy. Just something, if I'm completely honest, I don't think I got the patience for. I'd rather play other people's content. What's this? Okay. So, yeah, I guess we just shoot you upward. Ah. Yeah, and it's also like the 3D Land world in the sense that you don't get camera control, which I'm hoping won't be too much of a problem. It hasn't been so far. Again, that's fine. I don't mind kind of having a fixed camera angle as long as it doesn't obstruct anything, which is something a lot of early 3D games and I guess, you know, 2.5D games to an extent kind of have that problem. Well, there are some really good examples where they were able to make it in a way that, you know, you never really felt obstructed. Klonoa especially is a good example of that, where they worked with that format particularly well. I don't know if the hit system is anything like Mario. I've yet to take a hit, so I don't know if this is one of those games where one hit kills you or what, but I'm gonna assume not, given just how much like Mario this is thus far. I'm wondering if you get any, like, other hits in this game. I feel like this might be one of those games where you get different power-ups and they're represented by the hats or something. Okay, cool, it tells you your time, too. I know this has leaderboard support, so I reckon that will be a good thing for the speedrunning crowd. Huh, no snakes. Again, wonder where they got them from. Wonder if I can. Oh. Huh, okay, I don't even have to jump on all the segments. back. Or maybe not. Expect to get everything on the first playthrough. This is a weird game. Passing the checkpoint, maybe I should have poked around. Oh, what's this and that? Okay, I guess it's pretty much the Tanuki leaf. That's what it feels like. Oh, it gives me the double jump. Cool. I'm guessing if I take a hit, I lose it. And, I do not want to do that, because it looks like I'm going to need it up here. Setting the coins. I think, again, Mario 3D Land does the same thing. If you have a power up and then you collect another one. Okay. Should most definitely watch it here. Bottomless pits aren't fun. Is there a platform there, or is there not? I guess I could take those. It would just lead to me wanting extra men. Okay. Because I don't want that to run out of me and run out of there. Okay, another one of these things. And, oh, this is like the 3D puzzles. Okay. This guy got these blue coins. Where have I seen blue coins before? Not 3D Land. Sunshine. That was kind of a bitch about Sunshine. Was collecting all those freaking blue coins, and one of the main reasons why, whenever I revisit Super Mario Sunshine, I usually just shoot for finishing the game, not necessarily completing it. That's another thing, with certain games, just trying to 100% them, especially 3D platformers. A lot of times, I feel like that's something that's difficult to get right, because a lot of times there will just be, you know, that mission, or that set of missions, you know, and you just really, really don't like it. A couple games that kind of do it really well, in my opinion, though, would be the Spyro the Dragon games. Aside from True Tops, I can't think of one level in that entire trilogy that I don't care for, if I'm completely honest. And even then, True Tops isn't that bad. It's more of a case of the level design being kind of convoluted, knowing how to set up those jumps to get to the distant islands. But other than that, I really don't have any gripes as far as 100% completion goes. So I'll have to come back to that one later. Alright. They're starting early with the snow levels. Oh, it's on the timer. Okay. Slowly sort my ass down here. I wonder if, amount of stars you get is based on your, time. I have a feeling that might be the case. Unless this is like, Luigi's Part 3 Land, where the, timer is just cut short to, make the levels a little bit trickier. I have a feeling I missed something there, but be some baking this rice in water. Ever respawn, but this will maybe give me a chance to go back and get our rooms missing. Or I just get jump on? I guess not. See if they respawn. Oh, cool. Okay. That was a bit too hasty there. Oh, I guess this is a boss of sorts. Okay, those connected cubes kind of remind me of the David East games. They always seem to kind of have a fondness for enemies with ball segments. High Seas Havoc and Joe and Mac have plenty of that going on. Just with cubes. Oh wow, okay, I wonder what the weak spot is. Is it the bandage on his head? What are you doing, my man? Rory. Okay. Oh god, you have to... Okay, I guess I just had to jump over that. I just need to do this one more time. Okay, I guess we get snapshots for beating the bosses. Charming though, it's got a cute look to it. Kinda like crayons or royal pastels. One S. Oh, you know what? This is probably the other special area. Okay, that's World 2. Cloud area. Ah! Oh, okay. I thought it was gonna kill me. I'll give it another shot. As I just, warp you back. Definitely missed something there. So I'm guessing this is gonna be one of those games where they kinda gig off the more difficult stuff to special areas. Okay, I got the star there. I guess I'll do one more bout with this to see if I can get the other one in the middle there. One thing I wish they may have put in there is like an instant retry option, so I have to beep boop back, boot it back out to the menu just to go back in, but that's okay, I suppose. I don't see that option in a lot of games, but just knowing that this served as a mobile game, I'm kind of surprised if it isn't there. But, oh well. You know what, I'm wondering. Jump down. Okay, there we go. And I think that's probably where I'm going to stop it for this video, because I kind of just wanted to get some first impressions to kind of see what this game was about. My opinion of it so far, it's definitely inspired by Super Mario 3D Land. That much is painfully obvious. And this interface here kind of gives it the mobile vibes, but I gotta say, this is a lot better than a lot of platformers I have played. The feeling, the sense of motion, the jumping, all of that is spot on. Even if it isn't really groundbreaking in any way, it's just nice to see more 3D platformers. And as someone that played 3D Land to death, this is definitely something I'm gonna find myself getting into and trying to complete. And I would suggest the same if that was kind of your thing. If you like 3D Land, I can definitely say you're gonna like this. It's currently $8 on Steam. I'm pretty sure you can get it for cheaper on mobile, but then you have to contend with the touchscreen controls, which aren't for me, I can't say. This seems to be working just fine with my PS4 controller, which is what I pretty much use on any kind of PC game or any kind of thing. I kind of have an option in that. I hope you like this video. Be sure.